The show is called Human Target. It is on Wednesdays at 8 p.m. It is a big hit, and one of the reasons why it's a big hit is the human target himself, Mark Valley.
Yeah, welcome to Good Day New York. I see that guys are all excited about having you here. Of course, the women are as well, but I notice typically when the good-looking guys come in, it's the women that flock and ask for pictures.
Are you hitting on him? Because stop it, all right? Come on.
I didn't ask for a picture just yet.
Congratulations on all your success.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm having a great time on this show.
The show is it's on you. You're
the
star.
Too. I'm having a good time here. Everybody wants to talk to me. And
I know. I see your fans are lining up. Now, this is the first show, really. I mean, I loved Fringe, and I remember the very first episode. You were the love interest of that main character, but you got killed off in the first episode. You kept coming back in a recurring role, sort of in her mind.
Yeah, I always thought I got a lot of work on that show for somebody who died in the pilot.
Yeah, you did. Now, tell us about this show, though.
This show is called Human Target. It's a one-hour drama. It's an action show from Fox. It's got a little wink of humor. It's something that hasn't really been done in a while. It's on Wednesdays at 8 p.m. in case we get cut off. But anyway, which is tomorrow night at 8 p.m. It's like something we haven't seen in a long time, kind of like Magnum P.I., maybe Mission Impossible, a little bit of $6 Million Man.
And it's got a cool theme song, too. You got good music.
It does. It actually has the largest orchestra of any television show ever.
Let's see Mark Valley in The Human Target. Roll it.
Vincent Kahn won this tournament back in the 80s, what, four times? Greatest heavyweight fighter nobody's ever heard of.
Not bad.
I did my homework. So I also know you're not Prentice's arm candy.
That's powerful stuff, Mark. You do your homework and you hit the gym, too.
Yeah, yes. Actually, do you draw on your background?
You went to West Point.
It
was in the first Gulf War, yeah.
Do you find that you draw on your background there?
Well, sometimes. Initially.
There you are as a cadet, by the way.
Yeah, look at that.
A cadet.
Look at that bright, shiny,
you look
idealistic
the same.
Young man.
You look the same. I want to ask you this, though. You were in the military for a long time. You were an officer.
Yes.
Now,
yes,
when
sir.
You're
a lieutenant colonel now, so.
Carry on.
You know?
But when you're an officer, you're in charge. You have people work for you. Sometimes when you're on the set and you're an actor, they tell you what to do. The director says, do this.
Yeah.
They'll change. Is that ever?
Well, do you know what, I thought of? At least one of the things I learned at West Point was that the people that I really respected were the ones that sort of led by example. And as an actor, you really have an opportunity to provide a good example. You're not really telling people what to do, but, people want to take care of you, want to make sure you're happy. But I just thought, like, that aspect of leadership is something that you can exert.
High maintenance, that kind of thing. For the younger actors, you're talking about leadership by
example. Yeah, have a good attitude, work hard, be prepared, and have a good time.
It's easy to have a good attitude these days. The show is a hit. It's a runaway hit. Do you watch it at 8 o'clock on Wednesdays? Do you sit and watch it when it comes on?
I haven't actually. Yeah, I did. Last week.
What's the lag from the time you actually shoot a particular episode to when it airs?
Well, right now it's about a month.
Oh, okay.
It's about a month or so.
Fast.
Yeah, but I imagine if we do get picked up in the fall, it'll be a little bit of a quicker turnover because we're doing an awful lot. It's really like a little movie that we're packing into 40 minutes. We're doing it in 8 days, so there's really not a lot of time. It's like
not a big if. I mean, people like this show. It's doing well. The critics like it. They like you, but that's pressure on you, isn't it? I mean, you're carrying a show for the first time in your career, really.
Really?
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
All right.
I try not to think
about it that way, but that will be all freaked out.
Oh, God.
Well, you're carrying it well. You can't watch TV without seeing a commercial for this show and our show, but your show, too.
Thank you.
Billboards all over the city. Now, when did
you
get into acting?
It's a perfect show for Fox, and they're doing a great job of promoting it for us, and we're all really, really grateful.
How did you get into acting? I was reading your bio a little bit, and it sounds almost like you started acting while you were also serving in the military.
Well, I was at West Point, and I had to give a speech one time, and I thought, God, I'd heard it year over year after year, and I thought, why don't I do it as something more interesting, just to make sure people will listen and pay attention. So I sort of discovered acting more from a utilitarian standpoint. It was like, I need something to make this interesting. So I thought, why don't I dress up as George Patton and do his speech, do my speech as George Patton.
That's bold.
It was risky, but you know what? It went off really well, surprisingly to me. I thought, well, oh my God, what was that?
You did a speech from the movie?
Actually, I was
reaching into your buddy's face.
When you reach into that pile of goo, well, you'll know what to do.
Who was that? George C. Scott, right?
Yeah,
was it George C. Scott or General Patton?
It wasn't General. It was George C. Scott
doing Patton.
So it was like a third-tier one. But
all right. Well, Mark, congratulations. Good luck.
Thank you.
We hope you get picked up. We're confident you will.
Thank you.